How's it going, you wish for the franchise guy? Come at you going with an episode of third Phillies franchise. Our 73-40 Phillies take on the 43-70 Arizona Diamondbacks. Jeez, that was a mouthful to say. We're rocking the powder blue tops, the gray pants, the really dark red hats, and some red shoes. Eesh, not the greatest look. Starting this game off, taking on Luke Weaver in 22 starts. He is 0-15, a 6.66 the devil ERA. 101.1 innings, 121 hits, 1.65 whip, 46 walks, my apologies, on 87 strikeouts. Not the greatest season for Mr. Weaver. I believe he was part of, was that the Paul Goldschmidt trade? So the return on investment not great for the Diamondbacks. So for the line for the Phillies, Segura, Realmuto, Harper, 1-2-3, Hoskins, Bruce, and someone else is 4-5-6. But JT Realmuto batting that two spot against the righty. Realmuto rakes against righties for some reason, opposed to lefties. Sends this one deep, his 17th home run of the season. Luke Weaver not getting off to a great start. I mean, sure, Segura did, you know, get out. But Luke Weaver, that 6.66 ERA, not great. I don't think I've ever seen an ERA that bad before for a starter. I mean, I've seen some pretty gnarly ERAs before, but never that bad. Bryce Harper up now. Harper's distance went deep to center field on the line. Drive's going to split the gap. Both outfielders are going to be sent running. Harper, you know, gets a second nice and easy. Rounds back. Stays on second right there. Maybe could have stretched to a triple, but I think that ball just hit a little too hard. You know, that ball bounced back really hard off the wall to the center fielders. Hoskins here going to strike out, looking unfortunate right there. I know Hoskins, you know, not having a great season right here, struggling immensely. Now Jay Bruce up to the plate, 2-2 counts, and this one deep to right center field, and it's going to clear the wall. Jay Bruce, two-run home run, is 15th on the year. Not as good as the real-life Jay Bruce, for whatever reason. But look at that, 3-0 right now. Two home runs in the upper pill of this Phillies team. I mean, this team has a ton of power. That's why we did bring in Jay Bruce for a bench power bat. Did not see things coming in certain ways. You know, Cole Irvin, all right. 12 starts, 5-2, 2.91 ERA, 74.1 innings pitched, 59 hits on a 105 whip. Pretty nice right there. 19 walks, 268 Ks right here. So one of the reasons why we were playing with Cole Irvin so much is just because he's a rookie. But get back to that in a second. Ketel Marte, Caesar, David Perron will start off the starting lineup. Jake Lamb, Wilmer Flores, Nick Ahmed for the 4-5-6. Roberto Escobar, Alex Avila, and Luke Weaver round up the 7th through 9th. But 1-2, I guess that's the second out of the inning right there. It's me, Matt, Caesar, Kate May, regional high school prospect right there, I think. Gets a walk right here of David Peralta for Cole Irvin. But one of the reasons why I've been playing with Cole Irvin so much, I bet you guys are tired of watching Cole Irvin pitch. A lot of it is unintentional. I'll just pick a game, sim to it, and it's just Cole Irvin's day of pitching. Like, I play one game a month, unless it's, like, MLB debuts, or it's, like, milestone games, as Scott Kingery strikes out right here to lead off the second inning. But unless it's, like, those kind of innings right there, or games right there, I'm not necessarily doing it on purpose. I'm not trying to do it. I'm not trying to have three straight games of Cole Irvin pitching. I'm literally just sitting there and picking random base, submitting to it, and I play it. I don't really see who's playing before it until I get into the game. But that's the main reason why I play with Cole Irvin a lot. I mean, I'm trying to get him Rookie of the Year. It'd be super great to get him Rookie of the Year. I mean, we have a ton of rookie prospects coming up. We have Adam Haseley. We have Jordan Alvarez when he comes up. He's going to be the Jay Bruce, the words are hard, Jay Bruce replacement. That big righty power bat in right field. I mean, we have Alec Baum, who I'm trying to figure out what to do with. I mean, we have a lot of players that I want to use effectively. I think we have probably one to three too many outfielders prospect wise. I mean, we signed Sehei Ubayashi. That was to be our more or less fourth outfielder right there, to have a Moniak, Hazley, and Harper outfield. But then we signed Kyler Murray, who would be a fun player to play with. All right. Then we traded for Yordan Alvarez. So now Ubayashi is, kicked out, and Mickey Moniak is, I mean, more or less pushed in to be in that fourth outfielder just because of his ability right there, his, ability to be a better player. Especially if you can lock him up long term. But I don't know. I think with Alec Bohm too, Alec Bohm's a third baseman. We've been playing Bryce Harper at third base for the majority of the season. He's doing great at third base. I mean, he's hitting great power right there. I mean, I've had no problem with him fielding. I've had more problems. I don't know, have I done that yet? Have I moved him there yet? I know I've tried him out there before. I'm not sure if I've actually moved him there. But yeah, I've tried out Bryce Harper at third base, just did some like testing between games, and I think, I don't know, maybe I consider moving Bryce Harper to third base if that would be an option. I mean, I'm trying to keep this somewhat realistic. I mean, more like 45% realistic, 50, 45% realistic, you know what I mean? I mean, that's, I don't know, it's part of it. I mean, I don't know. They said the whole free agents thing that they were going to move Bryce, if the Yankees was on there, they'd try and play him at first base because he has the pure raw talent. I mean, the man moved from catcher to the outfield. So he has the ability to, move positions. He's done it before. But I don't know. Scratching my head right now, trying to figure out what's up with this current lineup, what we're doing with everything, really. I mean, even then we have Nick Williams, Jake Arrieta, guys who, I don't know, maybe want to be traded, maybe not want to be traded. Jeez, it's just, we have so many players. I mean, I'm not even sure who I'd trade for, because I feel like if I were to trade someone, I'm just moving someone else out of a position that they belong in. So my starting rotation has a lot of holes in it currently. Well, holes in a sense that I'm not sure going into next season who my rotation's gonna be. I know I have Aaron Nola locked in at the one. Okay. As Rhys Hoskins is the three-run bomb right here. Way to go, Rhys. Rhys Hoskins is all the hits he can get right here. All the home runs, all the hits. It's his 38th on the season. Three-run bomb. I think he's like five home runs still behind Charlie Blackman, who's just murdering it this season for no reason whatsoever. And I do not appreciate it one bit. But where was I? Oof. All right, rotation. Rotation being, we have Nola at the one. Lock. I want to trade Arrieta. Get that $25 million off the books. All right, cool. So we need a two. We need a number two now in the rotation. We have Eflin, who I like. Eflin's hit or miss, but at least so far in my franchise, Eflin has simmed amazingly, like dark horse Cy Young caliber sim amazingly. So he's the three, okay? He's our three. Four and a five. I mean, right now, I'm looking at maybe giving the fifth spot to Cole Irvin, just because he's done pretty well so far this year. I feel like he deserves it. I know Cole Hamels is a free agent, so maybe I want to do a double lefty lineup, a rotation. Maybe that's too many lefties in the rotation. But I don't know. I think what I need to do really is just sit down, wait for the whole thing to come happen, sign some players, sign some depth, because we traded for a limit. We traded that Nick Pivetta trade. Yeah, that Nick Pivetta trade. We got a bunch of pitchers back. We got Nick Kingham and Chad Kuhl back, as well as a shortstop Cole Tucker. we have to factor in those guys. Like, hey, Kingham's an A potential. Like, Kingham has some ability to pitch somewhere in him, if it's, good ability to pitch, or if it's, the ability that he could throw a strike one out of every six pitches. That's still an ability to pitch. So does someone like that get a shot at the rotation? Do we throw him at the five? Do we move up? Do we sign someone like a Cole Hamels? Have a rotation as a Nola Hamels, Eflin, Irvin, just at that fifth spot, just run through everyone in the organization from Chad Kuhl to De Los Santos to Suarez to even Adonis Medina. Because I think he's gonna be part of the future right there for this rotation. I don't think he's gonna be up this season, but ooh, look at this. Speaking of up this season, Cole Irvin is complaining about a mild dull pain in his back of his neck as precaution. He'll be removed from the game. And I mean, Irvin was dealing right now. I think he had like 12 strikeouts right now. I think I'm not entirely sure. I gotta go back and look before this, but he had a ton of strikeouts. But in will come Victor Ryan on 14 games. He has 5-0, 2 saves, a 0 ERA, 13 innings, 15 Ks. Lefty's batting 0.050. Righty's batting a measly 0.160. But yeah, dirty, dirty, dirty. He's gonna come in, strike the first man he sees out right here. So that's a great way to start the game. Yeah, he was not too happy right here. He's like, oh, that's a ball right there. Starts kicking the dirt. He turns around, and the umpire's like, hey, you struck out. Leave. Be gone, child. Yeah, he's still confused by it. Gonna follow that first strike of this another strikeout here. Matt Caesar goes down swinging. He's not having a good game. This is what, second strike out of the game? Third strike? I think it's the second. Yeah. It's a common theme right here. A lot of people are striking out if you pay attention. But it'll come Jose Alvarez for the Phillies right here. So we just did I just not show I was batting last inning? Guess not. Okay. But Jose Alvarez strike out the first batter right here. I mean, we're up 10-2. I believe that's in line currently with how things are supposed to be. Two strikeouts so far for Alvarez right here, second of the game. And we have another lefty coming in, because I'm pretty sure Alvarez is just our lefty specialist. But, I mean, speaking of Alvarez, I mean, he is not impressing the manager core at all. But we're going to keep him in here for the righty Flores, and Flores in a strikeout looking. Rex comes in, 1-2-3 strikes out the side right here. Way to go, Jose Alvarez. But, speaking of Jose Alvarez and his bullpen, I mean, this bullpen is up in the air too. This bullpen has four people locked in for it going into next season. That's Seranthony Domínguez, Hector Neris, Victor Arano, and Odubre Ramos. I know Odubre Ramos currently isn't with the team, but he will be with the team if he's like. I just felt like he needed more seasoning. I mean, Pat Neshek, not bringing him back. Juan Nicasio is doing god awful. Not bringing him back. So I'm going to try and have an 8-man rotation, 4-man bench. I think that's just gonna be better for this. Just gives us more options. I mean, we only have one lefty in our pen currently. I mean, if you want to use Cole Irvin technically as a lefty out of the pen, we can, but I don't think we have the ability to really start one of our relief pitchers in the how long is I mean, yeah, we have Jared Eichhoff, I guess, but I'm not trusting him to be like the guy. But Nick Williams right here, a sim monster right here if he actually starts. Problem is, we just don't have a place for him. I think something we do with Nick Williams, we could trade him. Fix his potential, because I think OSFM kind of messed up at first a little bit. So what we do is we just fix the potential and we release him to the world. We find someone who wants to trade for him, and we bring a hole back. We fix our bullpen. We bring in a Jose Leclerc. We bring in a dominant lefty like Will Smith, maybe. I definitely think I want to look for a very good lefty, maybe for him. Lefty has some prospects, hopefully. I know, like, we could have gotten Joey Bart from the Giants, so maybe if they still have one Mr. Will Smith, we can look to trade for Joey Bart and Will Smith, because I get JT Realmuto is our current catcher, but he's He's pretty old. I mean, we're always looking for the backup catcher. I mean, we have MJ Melendez currently in the farm system, but hey, maybe we look to get someone better. But it'll come straight Anthony Dominguez in 52 games. He's 3-1, 18 saves, 3.10 ERA, 52.1 innings, pitched 66 Ks. Lefties are batting measly 176, and righties are batting a whopping 202 against him. And you know, this right here is a strikeout looking. That's not a great start up to the inning for that man. But top of the ninth right now. JT, there's a strikeout on the pitch way outside of the zone right now. Not the greatest look for him currently, one bit at all. 3-2 count here for Bryce Harper. Harper's going to hold up his swing, and that's going to be a walk for Harper on the game. Lopez not too thrilled about that. He definitely thought that that ball was, you know, swung on. I mean, hey, if I was the opposing pitcher, I would always lobby that every pitch is swung on, you know? Well, the 10-4 lead right here, Reese Hoskins gonna get locked right here as Lopez still cannot find the strike zone. Quite unfortunate for that young man right there. Not entirely sure how young that man is, but I'm gonna call him a young man. Jay Bruce up now, and Jay Bruce, after two strike walk, gets plunked. The second batter hit this game. I mean, third if you want to count the time that Irvin plunked Alex Avila after he went deep. But getting to the bottom of the ninth inning right here, Dominguez gonna start off with a strikeout of Nick Ahmed. No, one out in the inning so far. No, 1-1 count right here. And now one of our guys got plunked. One of your guys got plunked right here. This time the flamethrower Dominguez sends it right into the back of Marte. I believe that's who that was. Alex Avila's gonna strike out looking right here. I mean, where he goes, Saranthi, just lock it up right there. It'll come Drew Ellis. Oh boy, the power hitting pincher batting a measly 183, 11 RBIs, no stolen bases, and no home runs on the season for the young man. And he is going to strike out three on the 9-mile fastball. Dominguez puts his arms up in celebration. Kapler getting congratulated by teams, by, I guess, teammates, players, whatever you want to call it. But this Phillies team does get a nice 10-4 victory right here. Jay Bruce, Andrew McCutchen, Bryce Harper all in the outfield right there. And this is a fun team to watch. We got some good players on it. Hopefully, we can keep this winning going. But if you guys like this episode, make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe. If you guys have missed any episodes, check the playlist down below. And, you know, what do you think? Do you think this Phillies team can use from a dominant lefty? Do you think we say, hey, scrap the whole Cole Hamels idea and go after a Robbie Ray or a Zach Greinke? I mean, those things could work. But play of the game goes to JT Realmuto, home run, two RBIs right there. Bunch of strikeouts right there. Victor Arnold does get the win. Bunt time on YouTube, definitely like, comment, subscribe. Peace out, rock on, stay classy before you go. Is Bryce Harper overrated or is Manny Machado overrated? Which one? I think it's both.